What is going on, people? Today again from Ceasar Graphix. Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and remember to check the notification box so you will be notified when I post my tutorials. Okay, today I am so excited. I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make this lovely looking movie poster. So this is what the end result of what we're going to be doing today is going to look like. I'm sure somebody is excited already. So without any further ado, let's jump into today's tutorial. So we need to create a new document. So I'm going to click on file now, select new. And so I'm going to leave this as 1080 by 1350 because I want to be able to put this on my Instagram page. So this is the normal portrait Instagram size, and I'm going to call this at P. So every other setting is going to remain the way they are, and I'm going to click OK. Then I need to create a new background, so I'm going to click on Alt and click on the new layer. So I'm going to click on OK. I need to change the color of my foreground, so I'm just going to make my hue 0, make saturation 0, and make my black 18 like the way I have it here, and I'm going to click OK.
So to fill the color of your foreground, now on that new layer that you created, you need to hold down Alt and click on Backspace to fill it. Then we need to bring in the picture of our bearded man, so I'm just going to drag this and drop like so, and I'm going to hit Enter. So I'm going to name this Beard Man.
Okay, so the next thing we need to do now is we need to boost the highlight and the shadow of this layer.
I'm gonna click on image now, select adjustment, and click on shadow and highlight.
Now you see the effect on the image. So I'm gonna leave every other setting the way they are, and I'm gonna click okay. So the reason why I did this is when we start applying the poster editor, it will help separate the highlight from the shadow. That's the reason why I added that effect. So now I'm going to scale this down by holding on Ctrl T to bring out the transformation, and we'll say okay.
And I'll hold on Alt to scale this down and position it somewhere around here like so. We need to bring in the picture of the cigarettes. I'm just going to drag that and draw somewhere here and move this here. I'll scale this down. So this one click OK.
So the next thing I want to do is I need to rasterize this. So I'm gonna right click and select the rasterize option here,
and I'll go to filter, filter gallery.
Then I need to select the poster edges. Okay, so what I'm trying to achieve here is I'm trying to split the shadow from the highlight. Now, as you can see, you notice we see it, we have this effect here splitting the shadow from the highlight. You see, we have the darker shadow here, lighter shadow here, we have the mid-tone, we have the mid-tone here, and then we have the highlight here. So that's the effect I'm trying to achieve here. I'm gonna make this be on 2 like so, and I'm gonna say okay. So I'm gonna create a new layer,
and I'll call this line.
Alright,
and so I'm trying to set the way I want to apply my brush to this layer of the dead man. So I'm just going to, so this is the way the smoke is going to go.
Alright, and I'm going to reduce the opacity of this so as to be able to see the look of my dead man. So I'm going to create a new layer now.
I'm just going to call this brush,
and then I'm going to hit OK.
So I'm going to separate color from N.
I'm just going to change this to about this point, and I'll select this type of brush, push this down, move the shape dynamic option here. Alright,
so I'm just going to scale this down, and I'm just going to,
so the whole idea of this is the color I'm going to be mixing with the picture of the dead man, just so as to make it look like a real act effect. So I'm just going to push this here, I'm going to drag this and drop here like so, and put a little bit of it here. So now we need to merge visible of all the layers. So I'm going to hold down or Control Shift Alt and E. Alright, like so. Now you see I have everything in one layer, like so. So I'm just going to call that layer
Paint.
I'm going to zoom in.
So the tool we're going to be using here is called the Smurge tool.
And then the type of brush I'm going to be using is going to look like this. This brush came with Photoshop. So if you have,
if you go to your brush panel,
I'm sure you are going to see the same brush I'm using here. There. So the spacing, we need to close this. Alright,
and I need to reduce the size of my brush.
So I'm using the square bracket to do that. I need to scale this down. Now, listen, I'm going to fast forward this video, but I need to explain some tips to you guys here. The size of your brush should determine the part where you are applying the smudge to. And I'm going to show you what I'm trying to say. Now, if I'm trying to brush this side of this brush, my brush shouldn't be this big. Alright, because if it's this big, see what's going to happen. So, but if I'm trying to brush this side, I need to reduce the size of my brush to about this point, and I'll brush. Alright, that's tip number one. Now, tip number two is, when you're applying your brush, don't do this.
If, like, for example, I want to brush this side now, if I do this, alright, and I extend it to this point, it's going to spoil the effect. So, the way you're going to be applying your brush is, you have to look at where the line of the color you're applying your brush to end. So as you can see now, you see I have this shade, this part here, this shade of this color here. You see I have it around this highlight here. Okay, so if I'm going to brush this side now, I'm going to make sure that my brushing should not go too much into this side. Alright, so I'm just going to brush in here like so. Alright, so if I'm going to brush this shade of this color now, I'll do the same thing. Alright. Now you see, so if I'm going to brush next again, I'm not going to continue like this. No, what I'm doing to do is I'm going to use my hand from my pen, and I'll continue my brushing from here like so. So if I'm going to brush this side again, I'm not going to brush like this. Okay, I'm going to release my hand from my brush and I'll do this. Oops, that's not part of the plan. So I'm going to do this. All right. So if I'm going to brush this side, I release my hand from my pen again, and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm sure you get the idea. If I'm going to brush this side, I'm not going to extend it like this. All right. I'm going to use my hand from my mouth, and I'm going to brush like so. Tip number three is this: when you get to the eye, all right, don't brush like this. So I have to turn on my guide so as to know where my brush effect is going to get to. So the next thing we are doing now is to make the bears, alright, this part of the bears look more coily. So how to do that is this: we are going to make a copy of this to have a backup of it like so. And I'm going to go to filter, stylize, and select the oil paint.
So we need to dial this up like so. Now you can see that the bears is beginning to look coily. So I'm just going to position this here. Right, yep. Okay, so I'm gonna hit okay like so.
Now it's affecting every part of the project, and that's not part of the plan.
So I'm just going to select the add vector mask option here, and I'll select my brush too,
and make sure this is set to the soft round brush, and the color of my foreground should be black. And I'm gonna zoom in. And so we don't want the oil effect to
affect the face, so I'm just going to brush like so. So we are going to apply the curve adjustment to this. I'm just going to drag this down like this. Alright, and I'm going to hit Ctrl I on my keyboard to invert the vector max of that adjustment. And I'm going to select my brush, select the transfer option here. Alright, and make sure this is set to pen pressure to change this to white. So, because the opposite of white is black, so we are trying to apply white to the vector max. So, I'm just going to start brushing like so. So, if you are using your mouse, I would advise you reduce your flow. If you reduce your flow, you're still going to get the same effect with the transfer option here. Because I'm using a graphic tablet, so there's no need for me to adjust my flow. I'm just going to reduce the transfer option. I'm going to go to graph adjustment again, and I'll dial this up. And this time, I'll hit Ctrl I again. And then uncheck this. Right, so we need to merge visibly again, so I'm going to hold down Ctrl Shift Alt and E. All right, then I am going to go to Filter, select sharpen, and select on sharp max. Now what this is going to do is going to make this look more like a real drawing. I'm going to push this up to about this point, and so I'm going to hit okay. So if I zoom out now, you see we're beginning to get that drawing look on it. And the next thing is to drag the drawing image from our exercise file, and I'm going to scale this up to like so. Then I'll change this and overlay. I'll dial this down to about this point. Alright, not too much. So let's add the effect of the fire effect here. So I'm going to go to the gradient adjustments. Alright, and I'm going to click here and change this to vivid lights. Should be on vivid lights. And I'll click here and I'll change this to something around, let's say, bluish. And this should be something around orange, so yes, I think this is not bad. All right, no, that's way too much. So I'm just going to this, okay, and I'm gonna say okay. So I'm going to push this here, and I'm gonna push this here like so. I think I should make this a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to say okay. And I am going to say okay like so. Then if you notice, we are having that effect on every part of the project, and that's not part of the plan. So what I'm going to do is I am going to hit the Control I on my keyboard, click on this layer now, and I'm going to select, all range. Okay, so I'm going to increase my fuzziness. I actually want this part to be part of this. So I'm holding down Shift now, and I click, and I'll hold down Alt and click on this side. Right, so this is what I want, and I'm just going to hit okay. Then now I'm going to select the polygonal lasso tool and just, you know, add this part of the selection. Then I'll go back to the gradient map layer. I've selected the vector max of that gradient map adjustment, and I'm going to hit Alt backspace to fill the color of my foreground to it. Now you see I have the effect on every part of the image, so I'm just going to hit Ctrl D on my keyboard to deselect, and so let's take out this part from the layer. So to do that, I'm going to select the vector max of the gradient map. I'm going to hold down Ctrl and create a macro selection of that selection. alright, so as to not make my brush go outside of this selection. And I am going to make sure that my foreground is set to black, like so, and I'll brush. And this needs to close. The macro selection is not giving me the room to see my effects clearly, so I'm going to hold down Ctrl H on my keyboard to hide it. Alright, so I'm going to select this type of brush now, and I'm going to check this option here.
Now reduce the size of my brush,
and I'm still going to check the transfer option here.
And I need to zoom in so I to apply the brush effect to some part of the smoke.
So the next thing we are going to do is, I'm going to switch back to white, because I want to add the light effect back to some part of this smoke. So I'm just going to speak like so. Select this brush now.
This
is the spacing. Let's add our next image, our grunge image. So I have this crude image that so let's add noise to this. I'm going to hold down Alt and click.
And I'll call this noise.
And I'll change this to overlay. Click on the fill with overlay neutral, color 50% gray box, and click OK. And I'm going to go to filter, noise, and say add noise. Alright, so if I push this up to about this point, it should have this. So I'm going to scale this down, like so. Alright, so let's do the final part of the adjusting of the color.
Ctrl Shift Alt and E to merge visible again, and I'll go to filter, camera
filter. Okay, so I'm going to increase the contrast, and so reduce this. Okay, and for the exposure should be 0.5, yeah. And for the highlights, I want to be able to see the lighter part of the smoke, so I'm just going to put that this up like so. All right and the shadow needs to go down a little bit, not too much. Okay, I'm going to leave the clarity the way it is. And for the sharpen, I need to make this more sharper, so I'm just going to increase the sharpen just a little bit like so, and I'm going to say okay. So this is the before and this is the after. So let's add in our text. So I'm going to go to my text tool now. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the D and the tobacco and put them in the group. So I'll hit Ctrl G and call this
title.
Okay, and I'm going to drag this and drop like so. So I want to bring out this effect, so I'm just going to drag this and drop like so, and I'm going to go to channel and look for the one with the high contrast. So I think I prefer green. I'm just going to drag and drop to make a copy of this. Now hit the Ctrl L on my keyboard And I'm just going to push this way. Alright, so I'm just going to put this that way, like this. Okay, I think I'm okay with this. I'm going to hit OK. So the next thing I'm going to do is to hold down Control and click to make a map preselection of the scribble effect. And I'll go to the layer tab now, double click on this, make a copy of this, and fill it with the color on your foreground. So I have this now. So I'm going to drag this and drop on my project, like so. And I'm going to scale this down. Show it here. Create a macro selection of the scribble effect, and I'll hide this. So then hold down Alt and click on the Add Vector Mask icon, and then you have this effect on the title. Alright, so thank you guys for watching today's tutorial. And if you have not subscribed, remember to hit the subscribe button, because I have lots and lots of tutorials I'm still going to put up for you guys. I'll see you guys in my next tutorial.